Imagine if instead of trying to work out what your complicated friends want for their birthdays, you could just go out and get whatever you like and then convince them that that's what they want. Life would be so much easier. And if you come and take a seat just over here, that'd be great. Just there.
Just there.
Thank you very much. Excellent. So, we spoke on the phone a few days ago.
Yes.
And I asked you to write down something you'd like for your birthday.
Yes.
I also asked you to sign the back of it when I spoke to you and gave you these instructions so that basically when you brought it with you today, which I hope you have done, you know that no one's going to steam it open or switch it or do anything with it.
Absolutely.
All kept secret?
Very much so.
Excellent. All right. Well, I have bought you a present. Now, don't get overexcited. It is in the big box behind you.
Right.
Right? It may be a small present in a big box.
Right.
Or it may be a big present in a big box.
Okay.
The size of the box will not necessarily give you any clues.
Sure.
All right. When you walk into a shop and you see something that you know you have to have, what is that feeling like? Describe it for me.
I guess it's quite sort of sudden and you sort of, you have a definite positivity about it. And often you'll go away and see other things, but then you come back to the thing you saw first. And
excellent. It's like, you know. Well, just take that feeling. I just sort of amplified a bit for me, because it is a really good feeling. It's important to understand that feeling of positivity that you describe. Okay. And also, very nice to meet you, and thank you for coming on the show. Let me explain to you how I buy gifts or presents for people, all right? And this is the best way to handle, bar none, the problem of, you know, what to settle for when you're going to buy gifts for somebody that's a little bit difficult to buy for, all right? Now, what I do is, rather than recycle the same sort of two-tier bottles of wine or box of chocolates, which are no fun to receive, I go out and I buy anything, and then I make that person fall in love with it, all right, by creating a strong feeling of desire for that object. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah. And it absolutely works. They get all sort of pumped up, you know, they get that feeling of that positivity you were describing. They beam excitement for it. And, you know, it's a win-win thing because they get a present that they love and, you know, I get rid of some stuff out the back of my kitchen cupboard or whatever. What I want you to really understand about this, because it's important, is that that feeling is so strong, can be so extreme, that it can replace the memory of what they actually wanted. So even though 2 days before they may have said, I want X, whatever that is, you know, like a really nice car, like a BM or an Xbox or something like that, something they really wanted, suddenly now they think they always wanted what I got them. You know, and they're like, well, why would I want another car or an Xbox? That'd be useless to me. And suddenly this thing is useless to them because they're so delighted and surprised by what I got them that they forget what they originally wanted. Does that make sense? It actually replaces that memory.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Excellent, cool. Good, so you can have anything you like. What's your dream present?
A BMX bike.
A BMX bike?
Yes.
That'd be fantastic. And that would make you feel great, wouldn't it?
It would fulfill a childhood dream.
Really? Is it a childhood dream to have one?
I never got one
when you were a kid, so it'd be great to have one. Okay. Do you want to have a look?
Yes.
Yes, excellent. Come and have a look. Ready?
Yes.
What colour did it look? What did you have in mind?
Red.
Red?
Yeah.
Have a look. Can I grab that?
Good, nice and light.
Yeah. Let's just put it over here. Sort of thing you had in mind?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Was this really a childhood dream to have one?
Yeah, it was.
Oh, you got all red.
I'm just amazed.
I'm delighted. Well, happy birthday. I hope it's...
Thank you.
I don't know a lot about bikes. I hope it's the right sort. And out of interest, what did you write?
I've got it with me if I still...
And what did you what
I
did
wrote
you write?
A BMX bike is what I wrote.
So when you came in here, you wanting a BMX bike?
Yeah?
Okay, well, that's probably not the case. If you can detach yourself from what's happened here a little bit, was it really a BMX bike you wanted when you came in?
That's what I'd written down, yeah.
You may have done, but that's very unlikely. Are you sure? If you think back, are you sure you're right? BMX bike is what you want. That absolutely feels right, doesn't it, when you think about what you want?
Yeah, absolutely, because that's what I wrote down, and that's why I'm so flabbergasted that it's there.
Take it out, have a look. No one's touched this, have they? Where's it been? Where's it been since you wrote it?
It's been in my wallet.
In your wallet. Go on, have a look.
No, even... I'm shaking.
Let's just have a look at the back. You know, you signed your name across it.
Signed.
This is the date and the time.
It was 1:10 on Saturday.
1:10 last Saturday, okay.
Yeah.
But genuinely, you haven't, no one's touched this since you wrote it.
No, because I signed it over here so you couldn't do it.
Let's just have a look. Leather jacket. Did you want leather jacket?
No, I wanted a BMX.
So why did you write leather jacket?
I didn't.
You didn't write leather jacket. That's your handwriting.
That's my handwriting as well.
This is what you want.
This is what I want. Yeah.
Right. Any idea why you wrote that?
No.
That gives you that feeling of
yes.
spontaneous positivity. That, yes? Not yes. this, you don't want no. that, that's useless to you.
Absolutely.
So you're happy with your present? As am I. Congratulations and happy birthday again.
Excellent.
Thank you very much.
Oh my God. I'm genuinely a bit freaked out, in a nice way. I came in here thinking, if I can suss this out, if there's some kind of thing going on that you know, I can work out logically, I'm just going to do it and, you know, I'm not going to be an arse about it. I'm going to play along and... but I'm stunned. That's definitely my right and that's my J. And I've got no need for a leather jacket and I don't know what's going on. What's my name? He's going to have me in a pickle jar by two. I know it.
So if you found yourself wanting a BMX 2, this is probably why. Very nice to meet you and thank you for coming on the show. Let me explain to you how I bike gifts or presents for people, all right? And this is the best way to handle, bar none, the problem of, you know, what to saddle for when you're going to buy gifts for somebody that's a little bit difficult to buy for, all right? Now, what I do is rather than recycle the same sort of two tired bottles of wine or box of chocolates, which are no fun to receive, I go out and I buy anything, and then I make that person fall in love with it, all right, by creating a strong feeling of desire for that object. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah? And it absolutely works. They get all sort of pumped up, you know, they get that feeling of that positivity you were describing. They beam excitement for it. And, you know, it's a win-win thing because they get a present that they love and, you know, I get rid of some stuff out the back of my kitchen cupboard or whatever. What I want you to really understand about this is that that feeling is so strong, can be so extreme that it can replace the memory of what they actually wanted. So even though 2 days before they may have said, I want X, whatever that is, you know, like a really nice car, like a BM or an Xbox or something like that, something they really wanted, suddenly now they think they always wanted what I got them. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Excellent, cool. Good, so, you can have anything you like. What's your dream present?
A BMX bike.